Hello everyone, welcome back. We're going to get in depth on making shaders that you can save right within Resolve, so you don't have to go outsource them to your folder and bring them into your media pool or use a loader node every time. I'm going to go through all of that. I touched on this a while back and one of my followers asked me to get more in depth on it, so I'm going to try to make this super clear if I can here today. It's a little confusing. The folder structure in Resolve, as we all know, is not the easiest to understand. If you go up here to Effects, Templates, Infusion, and go down here to Shaders, these are all the ones that are built in Resolve already, in case you don't know. Some of them are pretty handy. You just bring them on down to your Notepad and use them. I made this one called My Nodes. This is where I have all my shaders made and pre-built right in here, which is what I'm going to show you next. And then I have a folder with my projects, so you can save any projects that you're making Fusion right here. Okay. You want to start out going to your C drive. Then go up here to Program Files, the top one, not the second one. Double click it, then go to Blackmagic Design, DaVinci Resolve, Fusion, Templates, and Fusion again. You should have this folder already, but for whatever reason, I did not have it, so I had to make this folder right here. If you don't have it, go ahead and do so, and then click on it. Now here's where I have the folders that you just seen. My nodes and my project. This one here I just made. You have to continue with that, authorize it. I'm going to call it Text2, or Test2, I'm sorry, so we know what we're looking at down there. Now that folder will not show up over here on the left under Fusion until there is something saved in it, in that folder. Once there's something in there, it'll show up over here. Okay, what we'll do, we'll get one of our pictures. So we're going to click away right here. Shift spacebar. Type in loader. And hit add, and it'll go to a folder structure. It's going right directly to mine because I've been to it through this route. You may have to navigate to yours. We're going to pick this blue one. Now this node is converted. If you hover over it, it'll say loader 1, blue aluminum is what I called it, then loader LD. I'm going to rename that though because I already have this in my folder structure. Actually, no, I can put it in that new folder. So we'll go ahead and leave it at that. Then you right click it, go to settings, save as. I'll go to my folder, a folder that you want to save it in prior to putting it in the other folder. We're going to transfer it in a minute. And you don't want to put numbers in there. You want it to be a name. For some reason, now and then, if you use numbers, it won't work. Okay, save that in that folder. Here's the folder we're going to go to in a minute. Here's the one we're going to get. We just made. It's called Blue Aluminum. We're going to copy it and paste it in the other folder. The test two. This little box will pop up. You have to hit continue. Okay, now it's in there. And I already seen test two show up over here. So again, now if you want to find that folder, go to Effects, Templates, and Fusion. And down here is the new one. Now we have another one of those nodes. Now this node will carry the shader over from project to project if you save this as a preset or anything. You guys have probably seen my subscribe buttons I have out there where I put shaders on them. You have to do it through using a loader node. You don't have to save them in this folder. You can go to loader node every time and get a picture and apply it to it. But I built these. It's a lot easier this way. So click away right here. Shift spacebar. And we want replace material node. This is the one we want, replace material 3D. Now if you connect to it, there it is. Now, you can get right to this folder. I'm gonna go to my folder. We're gonna add this C. Now if I go to the new one, test two, click on it and then right click, select show folder. And there it is. Now all we have to do, now I already got this one made. Right click. Save as. That one's just called C. Copy. And paste. And there it is. Now it's in there. Okay, let's make a brand new one. My keyboard acts weird like that sometimes. And now we're going to go to loader again. Okay, now we can pick any one of these. Like I say, all these are is a picture of something. Copper, aluminum, brass. Let's do this dark brass. Like I say, it's got to have a name. If it has all these numbers and stuff in there, it may not work. And once you double click it, there it is. It's looking at viewer. You can see you can use it right from there. But again, if you want to save it, right click, settings, and then save as. Go to the folder that you're going to save it in, give it a name. I'm just calling it brass. I'll bring up both our folders. This is the last one. Right click, copy. If you look here, we're still in that project or that folder called test 2. And you have to hit this every time. Now it's in there. Then we go over here to our folder. And there it is again. Well, there you go. That's all there is to it. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you out, and we'll see you on the next one.